Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install MinGW compiler on a Windows operating system. And then I will also show you how to write a simple hello world program and how to run using our MinGW compiler. So let's begin. Now to install MinGW compiler, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar just simply type MinGW download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this sourceforge.net is basically your first search result, but I'll be recommending you to skip this first one, also the second one, and to click on this MinGW w64.org link. So this is our official site of MinGW w64, so I'll be recommending you to click on this MinGW w64. And after clicking on that, you'll be landed over to this official site of MinGW w64. And here you'll be getting this download link. So just simply click on that. I'll be putting this link in the description so you don't need to worry about the link and all. Right. And here under downloads, if you just simply scroll down, you can see that it is available for like several operating systems. Like these are all Linux variant. Right. So here you'll be seeing this MinGW w64 builds. Right. So just simply click on that. And you'll be redirect to this installation colon sourceforge link over here. So here you need to just simply click on this sourceforge and it will going to redirect you to this sourceforge page. See, MinGW w64 is available for 32 and 64 bit Windows, and see, after 5 seconds it will going to start downloading our MinGW installer. So our MinGW w64 installer has rightly downloaded, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can see that our MinGW installer has rightly downloaded over here. So you need to just simply double click on it to start installing our MinGW, and you need to provide administrative privileges by just simply clicking on yes, and you'll be seeing this welcome to MinGW w64 installation wizard. So let us first minimize our download directory. And here just simply click on next, and it is getting repository description file. And after that you'll be seeing this settings. So here under settings, you need to, you know, from this drop down of version, you can choose the latest one. I am going to choose this latest one, which is 8.1.0. and architecture, you can choose 64 bit, right, because I am using a 64 bit operating system. And thread, you can choose Win32 or POSIX. I'm going to choose POSIX, which is the default one. And exception, you can keep this default. And this build version, I'm going to choose 0, which is also default, right? So simply, you know, select your architecture and then just simply click on next. And this is going to be our installation destinations, so you can keep this as a default and then just simply click on next. And see, our downloading MinGW compiler has rightly started over here. So here you need to have an active internet connection so that they can fetch all files, MinGW files, from internet, and they can download it on your system. So this entire process will, you know, take some time, so you can, you know, grab a coffee and you can come back again. So I'll be also doing the same. Yeah, so we'll come back. And now, as you can see, that it took about 20 minutes, you know, to download all files and to install. Maybe it because of my internet speed, or maybe their server is little bit down. So it took for me about 20 minutes. And I can see it's telling that just click on next to continue the installation. So just, you know, simply click on next. And see, click on finish to complete the installation. So I'm just simply clicking on finish. And now that you know that our MinGW has rightly installed on my machine, so it's time to set our environment path variable. So for that, you need to go to basically your C drive, and then you'll be seeing program files. So just simply go inside that, and here you'll be seeing this MinGW w64 folder over here. So just simply go inside that folder, and you'll be seeing this x86-64-8.1.0 folder. So just simply go inside that folder, and here we'll be seeing this MinGW 64 folder. So just simply again go inside that folder, and then you'll be seeing this bin folder. So you need to again go inside that bin folder, right? So we are inside this bin folder location. Now all you need to do is you need to just click on this address bar, then right click on it and copy. So you need to copy this address path of our MinGW bin folder location, and then you need to just simply click on the search icon, and here you need to just simply search environ, and you'll be getting this ad to the system environment variables. So just simply click on that. What it will do is it will going to open our system properties window. Here you need to just simply click on these environment variables, and you'll be seeing these environment variables pop up over here. So here you need to just simply click on path under system variables, and then you need to just simply click on edit, and it will going to open this edit environment variable window. Here you need to just simply click on new, then here you need to just simply right click on it and paste. So what we are doing is we are first downloading this MinGW installer from their official site, then we are installing it, and then we are going to their bin folder location in C drive, then we are copying that path and we are pasting it under these edit environment variables, right? So that's basically all about it. Then you need to just simply click on OK, then again OK, then again OK. And now if you just simply minimize it, and if you again simply click on this search icon, and here just simply type CMD, you'll be seeing command prompt. So just simply click on that, and here if you just simply type GCC space dash dash version, then enter, you can see that our latest version of GCC has rightly installed, that is this MinGW w64 project, and the version is 8.1.0, right? So if we get this type of message, then it all means that our GCC compiler has rightly installed on our machine, right? So now I'm going to show you how to write a simple hello world program and how to run them using our MinGW compiler. So for that, let us first close this command prompt, then right click, then create a new folder. I'm going to create this C dash workspace, right? Just a folder name, going inside that folder, then just maximize it, right click, new, a text document, right? And see, they have recognized it as a .txt document. You can, you know, just simply click on view and then show, and you can enable these file name extensions to, you know, get this .txt extension over here, right? You can easily do that. And here you need to change it to .c, and I am going to also change the file name to hello world. That's all about it. So hello world.c, since we are writing a simple hello world C program, so I'm going to changing it to .c extension, and then just, you know, simply click on yes, and you'll be seeing that it has rightly changed with .c extension, and under type C it is C source file, right? So just, you know, simply double click on it, and it will going to ask you that using which app you'd like to open it. I have already installed Visual Studio Code, so you can use that also, or you can use, you know, Notepad also. I'm going to use just a simple Notepad, so that this Notepad is everyone is having, right? So I'm using that only. So here I'm going to write a simple hello world program. So hash include stdio.h, right? Then I'm going to create our int main method. Then I'm just going to create to brace, and then going inside our main method, and I'm going to print just hello world. That's it. And since I have created, you know, int main method, so I need to return something, so I'm going to return 0. That's it. Then just, you know, simply go to file and save, and see, it has rightly saved as hello world.c, and our program is rightly saved. So now you need to go to again this, click on this address bar, and here you need to just simply type cmd, then enter, and see, our command prompt has rightly opened in our C workspace directory. So here if you just simply type gcc, the name of your file name, that is hello world.c, so, you know, hello world.c, then give a space and then dash o. So this dash o is basically a flag that we are setting. So this o means output, and we are giving a file name for our output file is, I'm giving as output. So what it will do is it will going to generate exe file after successful compiling of our program. So if you just simply hit enter, you can see that it has rightly compiled and our output.exe file has rightly generated over here, right? See, our output.exe file has rightly generated. This output name is actually came from this output flag that we have set. If you have set it like, you know, some other name, like anything, like let's say you have set it just out, then what it will do is it will going to generate a out.exe file after successful compiling of your C program that we have created, right? And now to execute this output.exe file, what you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply type that file name. So in my case it is output.exe, so I am going to write that file name only over here, and then I'm just simply going to hit enter and see our hello world has rightly shown in our console, right? So in this we can easily install MinGW compiler and you can easily run your code. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and also please do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.